Good morning, students. Today we will discuss indefinite integration. So this is a chapter belongs to calculus. So basically calculus is of two types. One is integral calculus, other is differential calculus. The calculus which depends on differentiation is known as differential calculus. We have seen in first year. Integral calculus, the calculus which depends on integration, it is known as integral calculus. Okay, now we will discuss about integration. What is indefinite integration? What is definite integration? Its properties, etc. Let us see. What is this indefinite integration? What is integration? Listen, the integration, the integration is the inverse process, inverse process of the differentiation, Very simple. What is integration? I am telling that integration is reverse process, that is inverse process of differentiation. In the statement, in the sentence itself, what is integration? Definitely it will be depending on differentiation. It's inverse process only, integration. Please see, we have seen differentiation in first year. For example, if I differentiate a function f of x, I will get some function. If I differentiate sin x, then I will get cos x. Like that for every function. If f of x is a function, then its derivative will be another function, say capital F of x. Okay, I have differentiated f of x. Capital F of x is what? It's a derivative. See, this capital F of x is called derivative. This is what? Derivative. Derivative of F of x. What about this? The original function is called antiderivative. This is what? Antiderivative. This is antiderivative. If d by dx of small f of x is capital F of x, this we have seen, this we know. If I differentiate small f of x, that is a function. If I differentiate f of x, I've got capital F of x. We know that capital F of x is called, this is what? Derivative of F of x. What is this original function? It is called antiderivative of capital F of x. That's all. This is antiderivative. This is derivative. This is antiderivative. Let us see. I will take d by dx of F of x plus 1. Can you say what is its derivative? F of x derivative is capital F of x. 1 is a constant number. We know that constant numbers derivative is 0. So I will take some more. D by dx of F of x minus 2. What is its derivative? What is d by dx of F of x plus 3 by 2, what is its derivative? What is its derivative? Derivative of F of x plus 1, it will be the derivative of only F of x. Once derivative, 1 is a constant number whose derivative is 0 only. Here also you will get only derivative of F of x because 2 is 0. So derivative of, if d by dx of f of x is capital F of x, Then for derivative of first one is what? Capital F of x only. Because one derivative is 0. What about derivative of second one? F of x minus 2. Derivative of f of x is capital F of x. 2 derivative is 0. Similarly, for this also, the same function is derivative. So, therefore, for all these three, you can take infinite number of functions here. They will have same derivative f of x. What is this? This is derivative of these functions. This is derivative of all these functions. You can take infinite number of these. What is this in this example? This function is derivative of f of x. What is f of x? Antiderivative of this. So therefore, I can say f of x plus 1 is antiderivative of this. This is also antiderivative of same function. This is also antiderivative of same function. Similarly, how many antiderivatives can I find? Infinite number of antiderivatives. Therefore, what I conclude is, instead of writing 1, 2, 3, there can be infinite number. So, I will take d by dx of f of x plus c I take. What is this? This is capital F of x. I can conclude this. So, these are all antiderivatives. What is antiderivative? The f of x is derivative, the original function is antiderivative. Therefore, I can state one more statement here. If f of x is a function, f of x is a function, then the set of all its antiderivatives is called the integral of the given function f of x. This is another definition, another statement. See, so f of x is a function, this is derivative. The original function is antiderivative. What is integration? It is inverse process. If f of x is derivative of this, then this is what? Antiderivative. There are many antiderivatives. Set of all these will give us by this single one. So, what is this now? It covers all the antiderivatives. This function is called integral of this. Symbolically, how we write? We write like this. Integral of capital F of x dx is equal to F of x plus c. This is the definition of integral. This is the definition of integration or integral. See, this is what? This is a function whose derivative is f of x. F of x is derivative of this. And what is this? It is actually antiderivative of this. How many antiderivatives are there? There can be infinite. Therefore, set of all these, set of all the antiderivatives, family of all the antiderivatives only called integral. Therefore, this is integral of this, set of all antiderivatives, family of all antiderivatives is integral. Symbolically, it will be written like this. So, see now, what is f here? F is a symbol of, yes, f is a symbol for integration. This is symbol of integration. Here this capital F of x is there, no, which you are going to integrate. This function is called integrand. This is called integrand. And what about this dx? It is a phrase. It is a phrase. It states that you are different, you are integrating with respect to which variable? Dx means you are integrating this function with respect to the variable x. It is called an integral phrase. What about this? Here f of x, this outcome is called integral. This outcome is called integral. And what is c? C is arbitrary constant. C is arbitrary constant, which is integral constant. Once again, so this prolonged s, this is the symbol for integration, symbol of integration. This is the function which you are going to integrate, that will be called integrand. Dx is a phrase that states that we are going to integrate with respect to which variable. Dx means you are integrating with respect to x. If dy is there, that means you are integrating with respect to y. Generally, if a function, this integrand is there, no? If integrand is in which terms, generally we refer integrate with respect to same variable. Okay. After integration, you will be getting this function. The output of integration, after performing integration process, you will be getting an output. No, this output is called integral. This output is called integral. And this plus c. C, what is c? C is an arbitrary constant. Arbitrary means that can be any number. Okay. So this is the introduction definition of indefinite integration. Yes, we have seen the definition of integration, representation of integration. So which is very, very important chapter. No confusion is there. I will give complete information. Yes, in this chapter, first what we do, we collect some basic formulae, standard formulae. There are about 25, 26 standard formulae. So we will collect those formulas. Once you collect all those, then we will enter into other methods. There are some methods of first, what is first? First, we have to learn basic formulae, standard formulae, about 25 to 26 are there. Once after getting these formulas, then we will enter into other methods. There are some methods. First method, integration by the method of substitution. Next, integration by the method of partial fractions. Next, integration by parts. Next, integration of process of reduction. Integration by the process of reduction. So basic formulas are at most important. Total chapter depends on these basic formulas only. I will obtain all the formulas, basic formulas. You please note on a paper. When you are doing the problems, you keep that paper besides you. Looking the list only, you solve the problem so that you will be aware of those formulas. Okay. Now let us collect basic formulas. Please. According to definition, just now we have seen what is integration. Integration is inverse process only, isn't it? So I will collect some formulas here. Please see carefully. So we know that d by dx of d by dx of x power n, d by dx of x power n. What is d by dx of x power n? It is n into x power n minus 1. So this is a first for, this is first formula in differentiation. So now I have to get first formula in integration. Instead of this, I will take x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Now tell me what is its integral. If I integrate, what is its derivative? Its derivative is denominator, no variable. I should apply x power n. Therefore, n into x power n minus 1, that is n plus 1 minus 1 is n. In the denominator, what is there? N plus 1 is there. By cutting these two, its derivative becomes x power n. Okay, this is the derivative of this. This is derivative of this. What is this? This is antiderivative. What is this antiderivative? How many antiderivatives will be there? Infinite antiderivatives. Family of all those antiderivatives only integral. So I am reversing this. Please see. This is what x power n, no? If I integrate x power n, then I will be getting x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. This is one antiderivative. But what is integral? Integral is a set of all antiderivatives. Therefore, I should add plus c. What is c? C is arbitrary constant. For different values of c, this will give us different antiderivatives, set of all those antiderivatives only integral. Therefore, this is first formula in integration. See carefully. Basics only, very, very important. Yes. This is first one. Next, number two. In differentiation, we have seen d by dx of x. What is d by dx of x? We know it is 1. This implies, what I can write? This implies integral 1 dx is what? X. Plus c will be there for all the answer, all the integrals. If it is an integral, that should be a family of antiderivatives. Now onwards, for all the integrals, you must write plus c. If you write only x, that will be only single antiderivative. But what is integral? Integral is a set of all its antiderivatives. Okay? Yes, therefore, this is another. Next. D by dx of, we have seen in differentiation. What is d by dx of root x? It is 1 by 2 root x. Okay. If you take d by dx of 2 root x, what is it? See, Nana. If 2 root x is there, how you differentiate? 2 into x derivative is 1 by 2 root x. These two will be cancelled. That means these two can be taken on right side or you can take on left side. 2 is there in the denominator. Here you see after getting cancelled, 2 comes here in the numerator. Okay. Therefore, another formula. This implies, what is this? Integral of 1 by 2 root x, or simply I take root x into dx is equal to, I did not write 2 here, 2 comes on left side, no? Therefore, what is this? 2 root x. This is another. Yes. Next, number 4, d by dx of e power x. What is e power x derivative? E power x only. This implies, what is integral of e power x into dx? What is this symbol? I said this is symbol of integration, prolonged s. This symbol, this integration symbol is meaningful when it is associated with dx. If you don't write dx, it is meaningless. Listen carefully, point to remember. Whenever you write this prolonged s integral symbol, it must be associated with dx. Then only it is meaningful. So yes. So derivative of e power x is this. Its antiderivative is e power x only. This is antiderivative. If I take arbitrary constant, then it becomes integral. So therefore, integral of e power x is e power x plus c. Next, number 4. D by dx of a power x. What is d by dx of a power x? That we know in the differentiation. A power x into log a. Okay, right. Now I want the integral of only a power x. No problem, I can take. See, integral of a power x dx. Its antiderivative is a power x. What is log a? It is constant. So it can be written anywhere. If I write on left side, that will be log a. This is antiderivative. If I add c, that becomes integral. Yes, this is 5, of course. Next, number 6, d by dx of log x. What is d by dx of log x? 1 by x. What is d by dx of log x? 1 by x. In some books, they write mod x, 1 by mod x. See, you take any function, those functions are defined in their domains only. For every problem, we will not write domain, but the domain is must. If a function is domain, a function is defined, that will be defined in the domain only. If a function is increasing or decreasing or 1, 1 or onto, whatever it is, first of all, that function should be there, no? Where it is defined? In its domain. So what is this? It is a log function. We know. In logarithm definition, this number should be a positive real number. That's why simply we take x and we write mod, no problem. That is known. So this implies, now integral 1 by x into dx. What is this? It is derivative of this. Antiderivative. What is antiderivative? Log x. This is integral plus c. This is definition, log x derivative. Log x derivative is 1 by x. 1 by x integral is this. Next one. These basic formulas, they look very simple, but they are very, very important. For anything, any chapter, you take geometry, probabilities, vector algebra, physics, chemistry, integration, differentiation. My suggestion to you is, orderly you prepare. Order is very, very important, one by one. So you must thorough with all these basics, then only you can move forward. Okay, next we will take another. This is sixth one. No, next I shall take seventh one. D by dx of trigonometric ratios. D by dx of sin x. What is d by dx of sin x? We know cos x. Derivative of sin x is cos x. This implies, what will be the integral? Integral of cos x. Dx must be there. This is what? Sin x. So another formula. D by dx of sin x is cos x. Therefore, integral cos x is sin x. Next, number 8, d by dx of cos x. We know what is d by dx of cos x minus sin x. Therefore, this implies integral of minus sin x is cos x. I did not write minus here. Minus means minus 1. It is a constant number. Can be written any side, left side or right side. I will write on the left side, it becomes minus cos x plus c should be there. It is must. I have forgot here. C plus c should be there definitely. So therefore, integral sin x dx is minus cos x plus c. Next, number 9, d by dx of tan x is what? Secant square x. Okay, this implies integral secant square x dx, its antiderivative is tan x and integral is tan x plus c. This is the integral. Next, number 10, d by dx of sec x. What is d by dx of sec x? D by dx of sec x is before sec we will see cot. No, we should see cot. D by dx of cot x is minus cosec square x. This implies integral minus cosec square x dx is cot x. On the left side, I did not write minus. Therefore, I will place here cot x plus c. So, therefore, this is the integral for cosec square x dx. Next, number 11, d by dx of sec x. What is d by dx of sec x? Sec x into tan x. This implies integral sec x into tan x dx. This is what? Sec x plus c. This is integral. Next, number 12, I will write here number 12, d by dx of cosec x. What is d by dx of cosec x? Minus cosec x into cot x. Therefore, this implies integral of cosec x into cot x dx. What is this? Minus is there. I did not write minus. Minus comes on other side. Therefore, minus cosec x plus c. So, this is the integral of cosec x into cot x. Yes. So far, I obtained 12 formulae, integral for integration formulae. So, you please see, these are derivatives. I have written in the green boxes. No, those are integral formulas. Observation, please observe. We obtained integration formula for cos x, sin x, not tan x. We obtained formula for secant square x, cosec square x, sec x into cot x, and cosec x into cot x. That means we did not write now In the basics, we did not write the formula for tan x, cot x, sec x and cosec x. That means integration is quite different from differentiation. If a function is given, any function you can differentiate, but in integration that will not be possible. The given function should be one of the standard forms, then only you can integrate. Okay, so you please observe tan, cot, sec and cosec we did not find, those will come later. You please note all these in a systematic order. We have written 12 basic formulae, standard integrals. Now we will collect some more. Please see number 13. We know that d by dx of sin inverse x, d by dx of sin inverse x is what? 1 divided by root over 1 minus x square. What is d by dx of sin inverse x? D by dx of sin inverse x is 1 by root over 1 minus x square. We are familiar with these because we have already done these chapters. We know d by dx of cos inverse x. What is the derivative of this? It is minus 1 by root over 1 minus x square. See, d by dx of sin inverse x and d by dx of cos inverse x, both are same, they differ by only sign. Okay, therefore if you take d by dx of sin inverse x is this, cos inverse x is this, only minus is the difference. What will be the antiderivative of this? This one. What is antiderivative of this? This one. If you transform minus to right left side, then these two become same. Therefore, listen carefully. These two implies I can write integral of 1 divided by root over 1 minus x square dx. If I consider first one, its antiderivative will be sin inverse x and its integral will be plus c. Okay. If I consider this, then integral 1 by under root of 1 minus x square will be minus cos inverse x. Therefore, this can be written as minus cos inverse x plus c. This is another formula. Please listen carefully. These are basics at most, basic things only, at most important. For any chapter, basics only important. But basics, they always look very simple. What is there? Those only very, very important. If you take a building, what is important? Base is important. That will be inside the earth, will not be visible to anyone. Only these higher floors will be visible. But all those will depend on base only. Therefore, basics are important. Why I am repeatedly telling this? You may neglect, what is their simple form? No, they are at most important. You respect them, study properly. So this is another formula. Yes. So integral 1 by under root of 1 minus x square into dx. You can take either this or this. If it is a descriptive question, in this integral of this, you can take sin inverse x or minus cos inverse x. Both are equal, both are true, no problem. While in objective, when you are doing objective, this has come. For example, in a problem, this has come. Then what to write? Sin inverse x or minus cos inverse, both are true. But it is objective. In that case, you are supposed to see the options. In options, sin inverse is there or cos inverse is there. Whichever is there, you substitute that. Okay, right. Next number 15. We have d by dx of tan inverse x. What is it? It is 1 divided by 1 plus x square. Next number 16. What is d by dx of cot inverse x? Why I am writing these two? Because they are equal, just they differ by a constant, that is minus 1. This is d by dx of tan inverse x, cot inverse x. As sin inverse, cos inverse, they are also equal. They differ by only this minus sign. Therefore, for both these two, what I can take? I can take integral 1 divided by 1 plus x square into dx. Don't forget this dx and integral sign, both together only give sense. D is equal to, so integral 1 by 1 plus x square is what? You can write tan inverse x plus c, or you can take it as minus cot inverse x plus c, whichever is required in options, you take that. Yes. Next number 17. D by dx of sec inverse x. What is d by dx of sec inverse x? 1 divided by mod x into root over x square minus 1. Also, d by dx of cosec inverse x. D by dx of cosec inverse x is minus 1 by same root over x square minus 1. Therefore, for these two, we can take integral of 1 divided by mod x into root over x square minus 1 into dx is equal to, if you consider first one, it will be sec inverse of x plus c. If you consider second one, here minus is there, you should write on the left side, it becomes minus cos inverse of x plus c. So these are the basic formulas. Still some formulas are there. Yes. These are the three formulas. This is for sin inverse, cos inverse. This is for tan inverse, cot inverse. This is for sec inverse and cosec inverse. You please observe in the beginning, because we are writing the formulas of integration with the help of differentiation, definitely there will be some confusion. No problem. For everyone it happens. Once you practice this, it will be happy. No problem. Okay. Please note it down. We have seen integral formulae for trigonometric ratios, also inverse trigonometric ratios. Now we will take hyperbolic functions. So number 19. We know d by dx of hyperbolic sine of x, that is sine hx. What is its derivative? Hyperbolic cos of x, that is cos hx. Firstly, I will write all the six. Next, number 20, d by dx of cos hx sin hx. I am writing derivative formulas. Then d by dx of tan hx, it is sec h square x. Next, number 22, d by dx of cot hx, it is minus cosec h square x. Next, number 23, d by dx of sec hx, what is it? It is minus sec hx into tan hx. They are all hyperbolic functions. Next, number 24, d by dx of cosec hx, it is minus cosec hx into cot hx. Yes, before writing their antiderivatives and integrals, once you please observe the derivatives. They are sin hx, cos hx, tan hx, cot hx, sec hx and cosec hx. There are 6 trigonometric ratios also. We have seen their derivative as well as integrals. In derivatives, you see, what is the derivative of sin x? That is plus cos x. Cos x derivative is minus sin x. Tan x derivative secant square x, again plus. Cot x derivative minus. Sec x derivative positive. Cosec x derivative negative. In trigonometric ratios, derivatives are of alternate sign, first plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. But in the hyperbolic function, very easy to remember, first 3 will be positive and the other 3 will be negative. That's all. Now we will write the integral formulas for these. See, for first one, derivative of sin hx is cos hx. Therefore, cos hx integral is, don't forget dx, what is it? Sin hx plus c, then only it becomes integral. So, another formula. Yes. From next to second one, what is it? From this I can write integral sin hx into dx. What is it? It is also positive only. Cos hx plus c. Next, from this integral of sec h square x into dx is equal to tan hx plus c. Yes. Next one, from this, d by dx of cot hx is minus, first 3 are positive, the remaining 3 are negative. On the right side minus is there, I am not writing minus because I will write on the other side. Cosec h square x into dx, what is it? It will be minus cot hx plus c. Next, Yes, from next, integral sec hx into tan hx dx. This is what sec hx. I am writing minus on left side. Therefore, it is sec minus sec hx plus c. This is the integral of this. Yes, from the sixth one, integral, not writing minus, cosec hx into cot hx dx. This will be minus cosec hx plus c. Yes. Yes, these are the integral formulae of hyperbolic functions. Please make a note. I have seen hyperbolic functions, now inverse hyperbolic functions. We have taken 25 for no, now 25. So, d by dx of d by dx of sin h inverse x. What is it? It is 1 divided by root over. So, there are inverse trigonometric functions and inverse hyperbolic. You please see the difference. 1 by root over 1 plus x square or x square plus 1, no problem. So, this is the derivative. Now, I am taking antiderivative, that is integral 1 by root over 1 plus x square or x square plus 1, both are same, is equal to. Its antiderivative is this no, therefore sin h inverse of x. Okay. So, we have a chapter in the first year trigonometry hyperbolic functions. There we have seen all the hyperbolic functions, their domains, also ranges, also seen inverse hyperbolic functions, their properties, problems on them. We know that inverse hyperbolic functions can be sin inverse, sin h inverse, cos h inverse, can be expressed in log also. Therefore, this is also equal to log of x plus root over x square plus 1. So, I have forgot c. C should be there. I will write here. So, this is integral, integral of this is this. This is also equal to log of x plus root over x square plus 1 plus c. That means, whenever you get this, you can take this as integral or this as integral. In descriptive problems, I said no problem, you can take any one. But in objective, you are supposed to see the options. Depending on options, you select this. So, this is another formula. Number 25 in our list. Yes. Next number 26. I will take d by dx of cos h inverse x. What is d by dx of cos h inverse x? It is 1 by root over x square minus 1. This implies integral 1 divided by root over x square minus 1 into dx. This is also important. What is this? integral root over x square minus 1. This is what? Cos h inverse x. For inverse functions, their principal values, their domains are very, very important. You should take this as integral, plus c will be there, don't forget that. You should take this when x is greater than 1. If x is less than 1, then it is minus cos h inverse x. This is the integral. This is when x less than minus 1. Depending on the interval, you should take. For cos inverse, cos h inverse also, there is a log expression. Therefore, this is what? Log of x plus root over x square minus 1. This is applicable for both. This is either x less than minus 1 or x greater than 1. For both, you can take this. Okay, this is another. This is looking lengthy, big, but it is only the formula of this. This is integral formula of this. Next, number 27, d by dx of tan h inverse x. What is it? It is 1 divided by 1 minus x square, 1 by 1 minus x square. So, what I do? This implies integral 1 by 1 minus x square into dx. I can take this as tan h inverse of x plus c. Yes, now you please see these three. These are in root. This is x square plus 1, x square minus 1, and with this is without root, 1 minus x square. Can be taken as minus cot h inverse x also. Okay, these 27, if I not forgot anyone, okay. These 27 are basic formulae of integration, standard formulae of integration. You please make a list of these 27 on a single page. While we are doing problems, you keep that paper besides you. By watching that formulae list, you work out the problems. If you do this, definitely you will be aware of these all formulas. Ye formula sab aapko easy mein aa jate. So, you please prepare a list in order in a single paper. We will discuss some problems. Okay? Yes. Now, we have seen standard formulae 27. So, those are basics. Entire integration depends on those 27 formulae. So, you go through those formulae, you prepare a list, you write all those on one single paper, keep that paper besides you while you are practicing the problems, watch that paper and practice. So, this first chapter in all the textbooks, with these 27 formulae, you can solve first exercise. So, this first exercise is for practice. So, you go on practicing these models. Let us discuss, let us solve some examples depending on these 27 basic formulae. Listen, please keep the list besides you. See, question number 1, integral x cube minus 2x square plus 3 into dx. You have to integrate this. That means you have to integrate each term of this expression separately.
So I am doing this. This is equal to integral of x cube. What is integral of x cube? You should apply first formula, integral x power n dx. What is x power n dx? X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Very simple. So x power n plus 1 means x power 4 by n plus 1 is 4. Minus 2 is coefficient of this. What is there? X square. Again using x power n. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Plus 3 is there. What is 3? Only constant. In differentiation, derivative of a constant number is 0. But in the integration, integral 1 dx is x. Remember this. So what is 3? 3 means 3 into 1. 1's integral is what? X. Because dx is there. We are differentiating with respect. We are integrating with respect to x. That's all. And plus c will be there. So this is the integral of the given function. Next, coming to second question. Integral x plus 4 by 1 plus x square. Please see the list. What is this x? What is x? X means x power 1. You should use x power n. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. If you use that, you will get x square by 2. Here 4 is coefficient. What is there? 1 by 1 plus x square. What is integral 1 by 1 plus x square? It is tan inverse x plus c. This is the integral. This is the answer. Next question. See this. So here a fraction is there. There is no such formula u by v in the integration. Presently we are in first concept, first exercise. Only basic formulas are there. Therefore I will simplify this. This 2 is a constant number. I can write outside, no problem. Now divide the numerator by x. Divide separately. X square by x is x. And 3x by x is 3. And minus 1 by x. Very simple. Integration. Integration is absolutely formula based. Differentiation is also formula based. What is the difference between problems of differentiation, integration? In differentiation, if you know the formulae, you can do any problem. You can differentiate any function. You can apply uv, uvw, u by v. Anyone you can differentiate. But in the integral, even though it is also a formula based, here logic is required. So you should get the integrand. What is integrand? The function which we are going to integrate. That integrand must be one of the standard forms. Then only it will have integral. Okay. Now see this. This is equal to 1 by 2 is coefficient written outside. What is there? X. X the integral is. X means x power 1. N plus 1 by n plus 1. If I apply that, x square by 2 plus only constant 3 is there. Whenever constant is there, you should remember integral 1 dx is x. So 3 into 1, 1's integral is x minus 1 by x is there. What is integral of 1 by x, log of mod x. Plus c. This is the integral. Next one. See this problem. Integral 1 plus 2 by x minus 3 by x square into dx. They are all in standard models only. So I am integrating. What is integral of 1? It is x. 2 is coefficient. What will be there? 1 by x. 1 by x integral is log of mod x. Minus 3, which is a coefficient. What is there? 1 by x square. 1 by x square means x power minus 2. How to integrate this? X power n should be applied. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. That means it is x power minus 1 by minus 1. This is nothing but minus 1 by x. So if I write minus 1 by x, minus into minus plus. Don't forget this c. If you write c, then only it will be an integral. Otherwise it is only one antiderivative. Integral is what? Family of all its antiderivatives. Yes. Question number 5. See this. Here what is given? Integral 1 by 1 minus x square plus 1 by 1 plus x square. See the list. What is integral 1 by 1 plus x square? It is tan h inverse of x. Plus, what is 1 by 1 plus x square? It is simply tan inverse x plus c. That's all. Okay. Next. So, these problems, they look very simple. Yes, they are very simple. But these are very, very important because they are basics. For any chapter, for any subject, basics are very, very important. Entire that chapters, that subjects, they depend on only basics. Don't ignore this. Learn the formulas, basic formulas. Entire integration will depend on those basics only. Further, we will expand, we will extend those basic formulas. Therefore, they are very, very important. My advice, my suggestion, go through those 27 formulas thoroughly. You write on a paper, you prepare a list of those formulas on a single paper, keeping that paper besides you. Practice this type of first exercise problems number of times. Don't say that they are very simple. Yes, they are simple, but you should practice number of times, at least 4-5 times. If you have different books, you solve the first exercise problems of all different textbooks. Okay, right. See the next problem. This is the integral. What is there? Secant square x. Yes, secant square x has integral. It is a standard integrand. Cos x, for cos x also we have integral formula, x square, x power n, no problem. So integral secant square x is tan x minus cos x integral is sin x. What is this? X square, x power n. If I use that, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Next one, this is equal to c. Sec x into tan x, is it basic standard integrand? Yes, for sec x into tan x, we have a formula in integration. This is what? 1 by x, it is also standard. 4, of course, constant integral is x, it is also standard. So integral sec x tan x is sec x. Plus what is there? 3 into 1 by x. 1 by x integral is log of mod x. Minus 4. 4 means 4 into 1. 1's integral is x. Plus c. This is the answer. Next one. First of all, you should see the expression whether it is integrable or not. So see, x cube. It is a standard integrand. Cos x, yes. What is this? 1 by under root of x square 1. Formula is there. Okay, no problem. Now x cube. What is x cube's integral? X power 4 by 4. Minus cos x integral is sin x. Plus 4 into. What is integral 1 by root over x square plus 1? See the list. It is sin h inverse x. That's all. Plus c. Yes, coming to next question. Question number 9. This is equal to. See the integrand. This is integrand. U by v. There is no such formula. Therefore, it is not in the standard model. We have to simplify this. So see, it is integral 1 plus cos square x. In the denominator, cos 2x is there. Using cos 2a formula from multiple sub multiple angles, this can be written as 2 sin square x into dx. Yes. Now this 2 I can write because it is constant, it is coefficient, I can write outside. Now dividing separately, listen carefully. 1 by sin square x is cosec square x. See the list, is there any formula for cosec square x? Yes. Integral cosec square x is minus cot x. Therefore, it is a standard integrand. Next, dividing cos square. Cos square by sin square is cot square. See the list. There is no formula for cot square. Therefore, I will express cot square as cosec square x minus 1. This logic is required. Logic develops by practice, only practice. See Nana, therefore this is what? 1 by 2 into cosec square, 2 cosec square integral is minus cot x and minus 1, 1 integral is x plus c, that's all. If you want, you can take minus common, you write outside the bracket. Okay, next number, this is what? 1 by 1 plus sin x. You should not apply 1 by x, that is completely different. Okay, here what I do, I will simplify this. I will multiply and divide by 1 minus sin x. If I divide with the same factor, 1 plus sin x, 1 minus sin x, 1 minus sin square x, that is cos square x into dx. Now again divide separately because we are not having any u by v here. 1 by cos square, what is it? It is secant square x minus sin x by cos square. 1 sin by cos is tan. 1 more cos will be there in the denominator, which is sec x into dx. See, secant square, it is a standard integrand. Therefore, whose integral is tan x minus. What about sec x into tan x? Sec x into tan x or tan x into sec x, both are same. Its integral is sec x. Don't forget to write c. Next one, integral secant square x into cosecant square x, uv. Uv means integration by parts. For product, we will have uv formula, integration by parts, further exercise. Now we are dealing only basics, no? Therefore, I will simplify this. I will write this as, what is secant square? 1 by cos square x. Cosec square is 1 by sin square x into dx. Yes, therefore this is equal to. Now, I will write the 1 as cos square x plus sin square x. I can write divided by, in the denominator, cos square x plus sin square x into dx. Okay, this is equal to integral. This is not plus, nana, this is product in the denominator. Now divide separately. If you divide first one, cos square gets cancelled, you will have 1 by sin square. What is 1 by sin square? It is cosec square x. By dividing second one, sin square gets cancelled, you will have 1 by cos square, which is secant square. Both are standard integrands. They have integrals. What is integral of cosec square x? Minus cot x. What is integral of secant square x? Tan x plus c. That's all. Next one, see this. Here also I divide separately. If I divide separately, see carefully. 2 is constant. Cos cube is there, cos square. 2 cos will be cut. We will have cos x by sin square x. Cos x by sin x is cot x. One more sign will be there in the denominator, which is cosec x. Similarly, for the second term, sin square gets cancelled. We will have one more sign in the numerator. Sin by cos is tan x. And one more cos will be there. No, it is sec x into dx. Yes. What is this? Cosec x into cos x. Is it a standard integrand? Yes, see the list. This is also standard. Therefore, here 2 is coefficient. Integral cosec x into cot x is minus cosec x plus 3 into integral sec x into tan x is sec x. That's all. Plus c. Please see. Next one. Integral root over 1 minus cos 2x. It is not a standard integrand. Let us simplify this. What is this 1 minus cos 2x? It can be 2 sin square x into dx. So here root 2 is a constant number. Coefficient I write outside. Integral. What will be there? Square root of sin square x is mod sin x into dx. So this is what? Root 2 into integral of mod x is a piecewise function. It is greater than 0 when x is greater than 0. It is written as minus x when x is less than 0. Here sin x is there in the mod. You should know the nature of sin x. What is given? Given that x lies in this 0 to pi by 0 to pi. What does it mean? That means x lies in first quadrant to second quadrant. First and second quadrant sin is positive. Therefore mod of sin x is sin x only. Yes, now it is root 2 into sin x integral is what? See the list. Minus cos x plus c. Yes. Next question. Question number 14. See. What is this? Integral sin x plus cos x divided by 1 plus sin 2x. It is not in the standard integrand. Let us simplify this. So this is root over sin x plus cos x whole divided by what is there? 1 plus sin 2x. If it is 1 plus cos 2x, we have a formula in multiples or multiple angles. 1 plus sin 2x. What I do? I will write 1 as sin square x plus cos square x. Sin 2x is 2 sin x cos x into dx. Don't forget this dx. This prolonged yes, symbol of integration will be meaningful whenever you write this dx. Otherwise it is meaningless. Okay, this is equal to integral of what is numerator? Sin x plus cos x divided by. See this, a square plus b square plus 2ab, that means a minus a plus b whole square, sin x plus cos x whole square into dx. Therefore, this is equal to, see nana. So, we have just now seen square root of sin square x is mod sin x. Here also it is mod of sin x plus cos x. Therefore integral sin x plus cos x divided by mod of sin x plus cos x. So in this problem, no interval is given. In the previous interval is given, therefore we have taken exact value. Here interval is not given. This can be plus or minus. I can write plus or minus here. Then sin x plus cos x gets cancelled. We will have plus or minus 1 dx. What is this? Plus or minus. Integral of 1 is x, no? Therefore x plus c. That is answer. If integral, some interval is given, then you can check it. In the given interval, whether it is positive or negative, you take exact one. No problem. Okay. Next problem, you please see. This is equal to, this is also a fraction. U by v is not there. Let us simplify this. Integral of, I will expand this, a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab, 2 into a power x into b power x whole divided by a power x b power x into dx. Yes. Let us simplify further. I will divide separately. If I divide separately, a power 2x by this, a power 2x by a power x will give us a power x. Therefore, a power x by b power x, which is a by b whole power x. Okay, next one. Dividing second term, this will give us b by a whole power x. Minus 2 a power x b power x by a power x b power x is only 2 into dx. Now these three are standard integrands. This is of which form? A power x. A is a constant, b is a constant, positive of course, different from 1. Therefore a by b is also a real number. You can apply a power x. What is integral of a power x? See the list. A power x divided by log a. That is log of a by b. Plus, for this also same you can apply. B by a whole power x by log of b by a. And what is this? Minus 2. It is constant. Constant means minus 2 into 1. Minus 2 you can take it as coefficient. Integral 1 is x. Therefore this is. You can further simplify this. What is this? Log a by b. Log a minus log b. What is this? Log b by a. Log b minus log a. If you take minus common here, then it is also log a minus b, log a minus log b, log a minus log b, that you can take common. So 1 by log a minus log b. What will be there here? In the first one we will have a by b whole power x. Here we have taken minus common, no, therefore we will have minus b by a whole power x. And here we have minus 2x plus c. This is the integral. Yes. Yes. Next one. Integral x power 6 minus 1 by x square plus 1. Again a fraction. U by v is not there. We should divide. So x square plus 1. You should divide x power 6 minus 1. By this, you divide until the remainder is of degree less than this. Okay, firstly I should take x power 4, x power 6 plus x power 4 minus minus, these two gets cancelled, we will have minus x power 4 minus 1. Nextly I should take minus x square, minus x power 4 minus x square plus plus, these two have cancelled, we have x square minus 1. Still degree is the same, therefore one more time, x square plus 1 minus minus, these two are cancelled, we will have minus 2. This is a remainder whose degree is definitely less than this. Therefore, now we can arrange, we can write this as quotient. What is quotient? X power 4 minus x square plus 1 plus remainder by divisor. Now all the four terms are in the standard integrand. Yes, you can integrate this using x power n. Next, what about this x cube by 3? 1 is there, whose integral is x, minus 2 is coefficient, 1 by 1 plus x square, or x square plus 1, what is it? It is tan inverse of x plus c. Yes, this is the answer. Yes, so this is the introduction of indefinite integration. We have obtained basics, basic formulae, about 27 formulae. Those are very, very important. Entire this integration depends on these basics only. They are at most important. You prepare a list of all formulae. Keeping that list besides you, you practice number of times, you make practice. Then we will move to other, in the next video, we will see another things. Types of methods of integration. Okay, next. Thank you.